all governments have immense investments in aircraft. And to work, they must be kept flying. Otherwise, they get out of order. So they must be kept moving. That means there's also a huge tourist business, constantly interested in shuffling people all around the earth. And as a result of that, it's going to be increasingly a vested interest. And politicians will find it harder and harder to stop it in the interest of having a war. So what we are in effect reduced to at the moment, so far as wars are concerned, are experimental wars. Wars under small areas against people who allegedly don't matter very much, in order to test out our military materials and techniques. Because nobody can afford to keep a large standing army in which there are no veterans. So they must have practice. And so practice wars are carefully arranged.
Do you think that we really tried to win the war, or were we just fighting a war to perhaps distract American people from what was happening here at home? Certainly, the war was not ever fought really to defeat the Vietnamese, was it?
No, not at all. In fact, all wars since World War II, if you'll notice, have never been with the so-called enemy of the United States, the Soviet Union, and then later Red China. They've always been with third world countries as sort of a surrogate war. And the Soviet Union has never fought with us, our communist China. They have fought small surrogate wars with third world nations also. In reality, it was a war to prepare officers through experimentation with new technology for their role as senior officers, and these were young officers who were getting this training, for senior officers in the new world police force, which is coming. And in fact, is in our military now, is functioning as the world police force at this moment.
Well, I hate to say it, but I think that you're right. I think this war was fought against America, it wasn't fought against the North Vietnamese.
Absolutely. The Cold War was actually a manipulation of the people of the world to give them a fake enemy to pretend, so that the government could pretend that the reason that they were doing all the things that they were doing, building the military forces and developing the technology that they were developing, was to fight this supposed enemy, this ideological enemy of the Soviet Union. And they were doing the same thing in the Soviet Union, telling the people there that we were their enemy. In reality, this had all been agreed on by the Big Three when they met several times during World War II. And during these meetings, by the way, the reason why after World War II there was never another big war, and all wars were surrogate wars fought in third world nations, the agreement was, according to the documentation that I saw when I was with the Office of Naval Intelligence, that for population control, to keep the attention of the public away from what was really happening, which was bringing about a one world government, a totalitarian socialist world government, the destruction of sovereign nations, that they would fight these surrogate wars, and there would be no winner of any of these wars. And if you look since that time, no one has won any wars, and no one has gained any territory through fighting of these wars.